Good afternoon. With the raise of hands, how many of you know three women? Keep your hands raised. You guys are all right, three women. So now, if I were to tell you, keep your hands raised. Now, if I were to tell you that you were going to lose one of those women, how many of you would do anything possible to prevent it? Look around. Webster's Dictionary would define this moment and this decision as a movement. In 2004, the American Heart Association was faced with a challenge that 500,000 women were losing their lives to cardiovascular disease every year. And women weren't paying attention to it. And even more so, women just thought of it as an older man's disease. So the American Heart Association created the Go Red for Women movement. It's a passionate social initiative that was created and designed to empower women to take charge of their health. So you may ask, what is the goal of Go Red? It encourages awareness around the issues of women, heart disease, and its actions and steps to save more lives. The movement harnesses the energy, the passion that women have, that when women come together and when they focus, they can come together and collectively wipe out heart disease. It challenges women to know their numbers and to take the actions to combat their risk factors. It ultimately gives women the tools to live a heart-healthy life. So let me ask, what does the American Heart Association do? What do? We're a huge organization. We have the tools to set up every man, woman, child, community, and business on a path to a successful and healthy life, to be in control of their health. In 2013, we worked with our local legislators to pass a law that requires our high school students to be certified in CPR as a graduation requirement. Pierce County is actually known to be the number one place you want to have a heart attack because of bystanders that know the life-saving skill. So we advocate on behalf of underserved communities for health equity and ultimately access to healthier foods. We partner with our communities to advocate, to educate everybody, to know their numbers, to know their risk factors, to know what their blood pressure is, what's healthy, what's controllable. And ultimately, we collaborate with businesses here and we meet them where they're at. So whether it's educating employees on the signs and symptoms of stroke through our FAST campaign, whether it's, I'm a little nervous, whether it's through our CPR training for children and adults, but ultimately, it's just a greater impact for the community. So as we look at pioneers and we look at the American Heart Association and our preventative care, that we've been known for preventing and being a pioneer, and that the needs of our society and us having the courage to lead. So when we look at history and we look at these three women, Amelia Earhart, she was the first female in 1928. She became the first female aviator to fly solo across the Atlantic. A reporter asked, why would she do something so dangerous? Her response, never do things that others can or will do if there are things others cannot or will not do. Over here to the right is Katherine Johnson. Katherine Johnson was a name changer within space aviation. She graduated high school at age 14, went on to work for NASA, and became the first woman to have her name authored on a flight trajectory. She was instrumental in the landing for Alan Shepard, John Glenn, Apollo 11 and 13, and then ultimately when we go to Mars, we will be using her flight codes. And lastly, when we look back at our Dr. Nanette Winger, cardiovascular researcher, she was the first physician credited and known for focusing on women's health. So you may ask, how does this all kind of tie in with women and technology? Statistically speaking, when we look at those three women, we were supposed to lose one of them, and we would have lost out on the opportunity and their mark on this world. So the AHA recognizes pioneers and pioneers in this room tonight, the women that are in this room, and understand the pressing need for more women to come to the table for STEM programming. We recognize that the investment in sciences will continue the breakthroughs and will continue to put us ahead of medical breakthroughs. It's our movement and it's our future, because we truly believe in this program that we haven't gotten lifted off the ground yet, the STEM programming here in the Puget Sound. We believe in the talent that we have here. And so tonight we're actually looking for leaders in the community to help us to pioneer such a program that would ultimately cultivate our own community and our own talents to continue STEM programming. It's our movement and it's our future. Now, earlier tonight, I'd asked you, your three women, go ahead and picture their faces. Go ahead and just think about who they are, your three women. Statistically, you're supposed to lose one of them. Cardiovascular disease touches and kills more women than all the cancers combined. It touches our mothers, our sisters, our friends, and our daughters. Tonight, I'm just really looking for people who are willing to join in the movement, that are looking to really impact our community and really put women in the cutting edge and ahead in technology. I'm looking forward to meeting you and speaking with you about the opportunities that we have. Thank you.
Can you repeat what she said, because if I can
hear? She was just surprised by the statistics of women's lives that are lost to cardiovascular disease and stroke. So cardiovascular disease and stroke kills women 8 times more than all of cancers combined. And so it's a thing that most people don't know.
Welcome to Seattle.
Thank you. Absolutely. Well, please see me after. I've got business cards. I'm looking to just really connect with everybody and really truly meeting everyone where they're at. We do so many different things that just besides CPR training and awareness of stroke and heart attack symptoms, we do a lot of activations that really impact your employees' wellness and health and ultimately giving back into the community and making a lifelong impact.